Hi, this is Keshav here. Welcome back. As I said in my previous video, today I'm gonna start with Azure Data Factory. All right. So as part of that, in this video, I'm gonna just give the introduction to Azure Data Factory, and also we'll speak about different components available in Azure Data Factory. All right. You can expect this video definitely will cover a couple of questions. Those we might expect from both DP200 and 201 exams. Alright, let's get started. Before, if you are watching my video for first time and you haven't been subscribed yet, do subscribe for more videos from my side on Power BI and also on Azure. Alright, okay, let's get started. So, in the big data world, the raw data or unorganized data is stored in either relational data stores under non-relational data stores, right? But in its own raw data form, as it doesn't have any perspective to provide any meaningful insights to data analysts, data scientists, and business decision makers. So definitely big data required some service through which we can orchestrate and transform these huge data stores of raw data into actionable business insights, right? That's where these, you know, different ETL and ELT services came into picture, right? So likewise, even Azure also got its own service, that is Azure Data Factory, which is managed cloud service. It's mainly built for such a complex ETL, ELT and integration operations by allowing us to create data-driven workflows in cloud for automating huge data movements and data transformations. And also with Azure Data Factory, we can lift and shift existing SSIS workflows. Also, we can execute SSIS packages natively in the cloud through Azure Data Factory. All right. Now, in the Data Factory, for transforming the data, you can use either Hive, USQL, and also Databricks to transform the data. Okay. So, along with that, we can use some other languages as well. Let's not worry about them now. So we'll see in future videos. Okay, this is something about Azure Data Factory. If you look at Azure Data Factory, there are some key components which we should be aware of. What is pipeline? So in Azure Data Factory, we can have one or more pipelines created. Pipeline is a logical grouping of activities that all together can perform a task. Pipeline is a logical grouping of activities, those all together perform a task. In a pipeline, activity defines the work that we're going to perform on the data. The work that we're going to perform on the data, that is activity. Okay. For example, if you are, you know, extracting, transforming and loading the data. So here, extracting is one activity and transforming is the other activity. Loading also an activity, right? So we are performing multiple activities. Each activity, if you relate to SSIS, so there are tasks, right? Each activity we can say is a task, okay? So each task will perform some action, right? So here also each activity will perform some task, fine? So that is something about pipeline. What exactly the activity is? So we already, you know, spoke about activity in previous slide. So as I said, activity defines the action that we perform on the data. So generally in Azure Data Factory, based on the functionality, these activities are categorized into three major groups. Okay, those are data movement activities, data transmission activities, and control activities. These data movement activities are mainly used to move the data from source to destination. Okay, and data transmission activities are used to perform any sort of transmission on source data before loading into destination. Before loading into a destination, if you want to perform any sort of transmission and also if you want to apply any complex business logic, of course you can go for data transformation activity. So control activities, if you want to have any activities executed based on certain condition, then we'll go for control activities. Okay, based on certain condition, we can also invoke other pipelines as well by using control activity. All right, I hope this is clear. Just let me repeat again. Activity defines the action that we perform on the data. In Azure Data Factory, we have got, you know, three categories of activities: data movement activities, data transmission activities, control activities. Okay. So data movement activities mainly used to move the data from source to destination, and transmission activities to perform any sort of transformations, or if you want to apply any complex business logic before loading your source data into destination, then you can go for transmission activities. So as I said, control activities, if you want to trigger or if you want to execute any activities based on certain condition, or if you want to execute any other pipelines also based on certain condition, then you will go for control activities. All right, I hope this is clear. Now let me jump on to next slide. Here let's see what are the data sets and what are the link services. Data set is a named view that refers the data that you're gonna move from one place to other place. What are link services? Okay, generally this link services will be created before data sets. Okay, before creating data set, first we'll create link services, then we'll create data sets. So link services defines the connection string. It will provide the connection information to data factory to connect to external sources. These link services defines the connection strings. These will provide connection information for data factory to connect to external sources. Data sets represents the structure of the data, and link services defines the connection of the data source. Alright. So for example, if we are copying the data from blob storage to SQL database, we generally create two link services. One link service, that is Azure Data Storage, is required to connect our ADF to Azure Data Store, and we need Azure SQL Database link service to connect our ADF to Azure SQL Database. Okay, then we'll create two data sets. One is Azure Blob dataset and other one is Azure SQL Table dataset. Okay, I hope this is clear. Don't be confused with dataset and link services. Dataset defines the data structure, and link services defines the connection string. This connection string is used by ADF to connect to external sources, right? I hope this is clear. Now let me jump on to next slide. The next key component is integration runtime. So integration runtime is a compute infrastructure that provides different integration capabilities, like, you know, data movement capabilities, activity dispatch capabilities, and SSIS package execution capabilities. ADF generally offers three types of integration runtimes. You can choose any of them based on your requirement and based on the source you are pulling the data from, and also based on the destination where you are trying to load your data. Those three integration runtimes being supported by Azure Data Factory are Azure Integration Runtime, Self-Hosted Integration Runtime, and Azure SSIS Integration Runtime. So this Azure Integration Runtime is mainly used if you are running a copy activity between cloud data stores. For example, if you are trying to move the data from SQL database to, you know, blob storage, or maybe SQL to ADLS, or ADLS to SQL Data Warehouse database. If you are performing any copy activities between the cloud data stores, then we use Azure Integration Runtime, Self-Hosted Integration Runtime. In case we are copying the data between, you know, two different networks like private and public networks, for example, if you are trying to copy the data from on-premise SQL to Azure SQL, or if you are trying to load the data from Azure SQL to on-premise SQL, if you are trying to move the data between both public and private networks, then we use Self-Hosted Integration Runtime. Alright, next, Azure SSIS Integration Runtime. As I said, right, by using Azure Data Factory, we can lift and shift existing SSIS workloads. Once we have done that, if you want to execute your SSIS packages natively in cloud, then we need to create Azure SSIS Integration Runtime. Let me jump on to next slide. Triggers. So generally, what are the pipelines we develop, right? Those pipelines we can execute manually, and also we can execute those pipelines by using triggers. Triggers are the other way to execute, you know, the developed pipelines, and triggers determines when our pipeline execution needs to be kicked off. Okay, so currently Data Factory supports three types of triggers: schedule triggers, tumbling window triggers, and event based triggers. Okay, schedule triggers will invoke the pipelines based on the schedules, based on the time schedules, it will invoke pipelines. Okay, stumbling window triggers will operate on specific periodic intervals. Okay, so event based triggers will trigger the pipelines based on certain event. Okay, whenever certain event occurs, these triggers will be fired. All right, so let's not worry about these triggers now. In future videos, we'll go deep and we'll create required triggers to trigger our pipelines. All right, this introduction video definitely will help you to answer, you know, a couple of questions those you might get either on triggers or integration on time, even on pipelines. All right, in next video we'll start with case studies. We'll pick one case study and we'll try to develop the pipeline. All right, thanks for watching my video. Please do subscribe for more videos from my side on Azure and also on Power BI. All right, we'll meet again in next video. Until then, bye bye.